us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
Especially to them that love Him. And all the call on the court to His purpose. Amen. Pastor Eton, his wife, leadership of this church, officers and members, members of the Union Church. Good evening.
Good evening.
It's good to be here. And praise God for bringing us here safely.
Amen.
Amen. I think the bus got pulled over.
Did it?
Y'all get pulled over? Yeah. Across the state line and wanted to check and make sure all the paperwork's in order. And I'm glad about that.
Yeah.
But no speed or nothing like that. But as we were coming, a car lost control about, what, 5 or 6 cars ahead of us? And flew across the freeway, another car hit it. Bam, this real bad accident. And, but God in His grace kept us and those who were involved. No one was seriously hurt, so praise God for that.
Yeah.
So we're grateful to be here. Thank you for extending the invitation to come this way again. My wife and I are happy to be back here. We just recently returned from Haiti and ministry there in Port-au-Prince and Dabond and Léogane, and checking with our ministry churches there, mission churches, and schools, and God is doing a great work in Haiti. So I'm not going to give you an update or anything, but He knows it's on our hearts, it's on our mind, and so we're going to pour out our hearts about that. I'm appreciative for all of these pastors and ministers who have joined us here as well. I know you're not suffering from a lack of the word. I can go online and I can listen to messages from Pastor Eton. Get excited and shout myself happy. Listen to him share the word online. I just want to introduce to you our First Lady, co-pastor of the Union Church, excellent woman, my wife, co-pastor Lee Clark.
Amen.
Still recuperating from the trip, some of the fall, the first day we got there. Praise God, nothing broke or nothing like that, and she just kept on going, so I praise God for her presence here today. We're still kind of recouping from everything that we experienced. We didn't sleep a lot, and the Spirit of God just spoke to us a lot, too, about things that were going on. Also happy to have our associate ministers here, Reverend Sister Sharon Holmes. She preached this morning.
Amen.
Seated next to her is the one and only evangelist Sylvia Shackelford. She taught this past week, and I understand did a tremendous job in teaching the word, and then joining me here in pulpit, Pastor Jeff Caldwell.
Amen.
Church, and trying to see, did I miss any other preachers that are here? All right. Amen. One of our deacons, Brother Roscoe Middleton right there.
Amen.
Amen. Occasionally our children and sisters, relatives get upset because we don't introduce them. But Jesus has sisters and nobody know their names. So I don't have to tell y'all who my sisters are. Y'all. This is my older sister Sylvia, older Sylvia sister Sylvia. Wave your hand over there, Sylvia.
Amen.
And my other sister, Sheila. Where is Sheila? There she is on the corner right there.
Amen.
And our son and his wife right here on the front row. Amen. And niece is out here. Where is she?
Amen.
And everybody else over here, my cousins. Amen. We just one big family.
Amen.
So I'm appreciative to our choir for that ministry of music. Thank you.
Lord.
And also to our music team here under the direction.
Amen.
Amen. Under the direction of Sister Olivia Duncan.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I think I have identified everyone except for one group that is so awesome that they are just the most phenomenal group of people in the world, in the church. I think we have the best in the world.
All right.
And our ushers standing up. The second best. Now you're talking about on this side of the Red River. We got the best on the other side of the Red River. Amen. But we're appreciative of God for their service as well. I thank Pastor Eton for extending the invitation to come and share with you on this 107th anniversary. So we celebrate with you for these 107 years that God has blessed you this year, the Union Church. We celebrate our 40th.
Amen.
Yeah. Yay. So we're thanking God for 40 years.
Amen.
To culminate our celebration in December. All right. We're appreciative to God for that, and so we're just thankful to be able to be here.
Yes.
Don't want to hold you long. Just come to bring a word. You know I didn't preach this morning, so y'all pray for me today. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right. If you get your Bibles, and get them and stand with us and turn to a very familiar passage of scripture that I think was used also as a part of the theme from Luke chapter 15.
All right.
Luke chapter 15. Luke chapter 15, very, very familiar passage of scripture. Most of us know it by heart or have heard it preached on any number of occasions for various purposes and reasons. And as these preachers and pastors know, that whenever you go back to a familiar passage of scripture, it can be difficult to preach because people already feel like they've heard it before. So we want to search and do a little exegetical work to find out if there are some other biblical principles or nuggets that are contained in this passage that perhaps we have overlooked and did not quite get. So we're going to look at Luke chapter 15. The passage actually begins at verse 11. And so that's where we'll go. And then we will see what the Lord has to say. Take your Bible, lift it up and say with me, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
It is the inspired word of God.
It is the inspired word of God.
I believe what it says.
I believe what it says.
I believe I am what it says I am.
I believe I am what it says I am.
I believe I have what it says I have.
I believe I have what it says I am.
I believe I can do what it says I can do.
I believe I can do what it says I can do.
I'm ready to receive.
I'm ready to receive.
The word of God.
The word of God.
I'm ready to change.
I'm ready to change.
I'm ready to be transformed.
I'm ready to be transformed.
By the renewing of my thinking.
By the renewing of my thinking.
That I may know.
That I may know
what is God's good,
and
perfect will,
and perfect will
for my life.
For my life.
I'm ready, Lord.
I'm ready, Lord.
To receive a word,
from the word
of my God.
Of my God.
Amen. Luke 15, I'll begin reading at verse 11. And he said, a certain man had two sons. The young of them said unto his father, Father, give me the portion of good that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country. And there wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want. He went and joined himself to a citizen of that country. He sent him into his field to feed swine. And he would have fain filled his belly with the husk that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger. I will arise and go to
another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.